Ever since I did that episode inside the intake manifold of the Supra, I've been thinking, I wonder what happens inside of an intercooler. There's only one way to find out.
This is rated for about 1200 horsepower.
Look at how beautiful that is. I'm all done with the see-through intercooler, and this is what it looks like. Nice and clear. You can see right inside. Only thing I have to do now is get it mounted to the car. I got it all mounted on the car, all the plumbing's done, and it actually looks pretty sick. Well, there you go. That's how it looks when the car's let down, and I don't know what to say. I've never seen a car with the intercooler on the outside like that. I don't know. That's how it looks with the hood down. I kind of feel like taking the hood off completely so we can see all the piping, and I thought it was a better look, and it also allows us to visualize the airflow a little bit better. The air goes in that air filter there, into the turbo, gets compressed, comes out of the turbo through that pipe there, into the intercooler, gets cooled, out of the intercooler, up into that throttle body, and then into the engine, spools up the turbo, and then out the back of the exhaust. Now I'm gonna start it up. Let's keep our fingers crossed, see what happens. Hopefully this thing doesn't blow up. Oh, there it goes. It's idling good. For this drive, I want to get some very specific video game style shots. I also want to get a nice wide angle of view in the front so we can see the throttle body and the intercooler. So for all these shots, I'm going to be using this new Insta 360 RS. The cool thing about this camera is it's modular. So it's like multiple cameras in one. You have a 360 camera module. You also have a 4K module, which is just a straight action camera shot. I've been using these for a while. That's how I get some of these really cool shots. So many people ask me about it, so I figured I might as well take a second out and talk about the camera. And this is a perfect fit. I'll leave a link in the description below with all the information to this camera. Let's get this thing on the road. Well, that's no good. I already scraped it up. that worked out really well. The intercooler held up even under a little bit of boost. When I did that little donut there, I hit about 5 or 6 PSI of boost. I was being really careful because, yeah, I don't know if these tanks are gonna hold the pressure. Next, I'm gonna switch the camera to the 4K mod and then I'm gonna run some boost. I have the hose taken off the wastegate right now, so I got about 14 to 15 pounds of boost, which should be plenty. It's like 1,000 pounds of force pushing out on each wall of those tanks. E85 is $4.55 a gallon. Thought the corn came from Indiana. Well, it looks like the cover that I scraped on that driveway apron coming out of the garage came off. Oh man, that blows. Oh yeah, there it is right there. Pieces all over the place. That's what happened. Look at that. It's okay though. Tank looks good. Just that bottom cap came off. That kind of worked out, but it kind of didn't, because I have two parts to this video. This is the first part, and for the second part, I'm gonna take this car to AMS, strap it to the dyno, and run some serious boost through that see-through intercooler while filming it with the high-speed camera, so we can see what the air does going into the intercooler in slow motion. Originally, I was gonna do this all as one video, but I decided I wanted to do the first part, just testing the intercooler to see how well it worked and see if I had any failures. And I'm glad I did, because look at what happened.